We had a seedling fund, which we competed against 300 and some other proposals and were selected and teamed with the National Test Pilot School in California to try to demonstrate the kind of a large global type nonlinear aerodynamic modeling capability, which we think the fuzzy logic algorithms can do. We picked a little jet that can fly an unrestricted envelope, and it was instrumented already, and got some data with that, and then tried out the fuzzy logic approach. And it looked like the modeling was very successful. And what the fund from the center sort of sponsored was to see if we could go backwards from that. Now take the model that we just, the mathematical model, and put it in a simulation and see if we can make it fly like the airplane. We developed those fuzzy logic models from the flight test data and then went over to the differential maneuvering simulator and tried to develop the equations of motion. We didn't spend a lot of time and a lot of money to do it, but we got our quick look results that, yeah, it does look airplane-like. You could fly and spin, things like that. And there's still some things to work out, but certainly looks like it has promise at this point. What makes it special is the nonlinear modeling. So, and we developed the flight test maneuvers as well as the algorithms to analyze those. So it makes flight testing much, much more efficient if this kind of a technique works, much cheaper. You can get a high fidelity model over a large range of flight conditions very quickly, which is very unusual for standard flight test methods. There's a lot of applications. One in flying, if you want to fly an airplane and it has some problem, has a failure of some sort, not only can it tell that it has a problem, but it can tell what the problem is, how it's changed its dynamic capabilities. If you're a piloted airplane, you can use that to warn the pilot and give him new cues of how to fly the airplane. If it's a UAV or an autonomous airplane, it can reconfigure and fly itself in the best way it can to try to survive the mission, that kind of thing. Additionally, this kind of techniques help in development of an airplane, such like wind tunnel testing. Next session, we have a computer that's mounted in the back seat so that we can get real-time maneuver guidance and also be developing the models while we're flying.